As said, my colleague Xi Huanyan catch the flu and unfortunately cannot be here, so I'm picking it over. My name is Emu Koster. I'm the area sales director of Nijhuis Sewer Industries and would like to present you today something about a case which we have done for a chicken slaughterhouse, and it's about fat recovery. Where can we use fat recovery? Fat recovery, of course, can be done in those industries where there is a high content of fat in the wastewater. You have to think about poultry slaughterhouses, red meat slaughterhouses, palm oil, edible oil companies, candy sauces, all kind of companies who have a high content of fat in their wastewater. The standard setup, if you look to the wastewater treatment plant in these kind of industries, is basically you have a pre-treatment, which consists of a flocculation flotation step and a biological treatment, and then the industry puts the water either in the local sewage works or goes with it to rivers or wherever they discharge it. Any fat which is catched in the flotation sludge is disposed of because it contains chemicals and you cannot reuse it in any form. What we did is that in front of that classical system, we put it a non-chemical flotation unit. With the non-chemical flotation unit, we catch as much as possible solids and other material out of the wastewater stream without using any chemicals. And that gives us the possibility and the potential to recover the fat. How does that work in practice? So as said, we have a non-chemical DEF unit. The water goes to the rest of the wastewater treatment plant, and the fat or the sludge coming out of that non-chemical plant is put it into a disconnector, which is basically a kind of heated tank, let's call it like that. It's heated up, and it then goes through a three-phase separator, a tricanter. In the end, from that product, we have water, which we can bring back in the wastewater treatment plant. We have solids, which we can get rid of in the sludge of the rest of the plant, and we have a fat with a purity of more than 95%. Some pictures. On your my right-hand side, your left-hand side, we see the non-chemical DEF. In the middle, on the top, we see the tank, the heated tank, the disconnector. The separation, basically a simple standard tricanter. And on the right side, we have a boiler. In this case, we are burning the fat into the boiler and generating hot water and steam. One moment. So as said, we have a three-phase separator. You see a picture there of the non-chemical DEF sludge is already quite fatty in appearance. It goes through the disconnector, then through the three-phase decanter. And in the end, we have an oil, water, and solids. And this is how it looks like in practice. The oil on the top, solids, and the water in the middle. Since December 2019, we have a full-scale operation in a poultry slaughterhouse. The delivery which we did was a filter, balance tank, then a complete EcoFat system, and a chemical DEF. And what we do is we take the white water of the slaughterhouse. The white water of the slaughterhouse is the wastewater coming from the slaughtering process. You also have the black water. The black water is coming from the delivery of the animals, the cleaning of the trucks. So that's a separate stream in this slaughterhouse. If you look to the white water flow, roughly 1,400 cubic meters per day. And if you already look to the oil and grease content, roughly 1,300 to 2,700 milligrams per liter. So that's already a quite high amount of oil and fats. Translated to the amount is roughly between 1.3 and 3.8 tons per day. From that amount of fat, we can recover roughly 50%. The rest is connected to the particles which we cannot take out of the water. It also reduces the pollution on the physical chemical DEF, roughly by 25%. So it also reduces there dramatically the amount of chemicals which we use. So this is without the Ecofact. This was the situation as it was. We had the white water stream, we had the black water stream. You see here the flows, and we have the influent to the chemical depth. And in the end, we had a sludge which we had to dispose of. This is how it looks now. This is the balance. We have in front the non-chemical depth. As you can see, the influent to the second depth is lower. This was the situation. This is the situation. So the COD goes from 4,400 to 3,100, so roughly 25% reduction on the chemical loading on the second depth. The oil and grease, the total amount of oil and grease which we take out by the non-chemical depth is roughly 1,300 kilograms per day, which is a recovery of 55%. And once we put it through the disconnector and through the trichanter, we can save roughly 50% because we have some losses in the solids and we have some losses in the water which is going back into the system. Basically because you have emulsions which you don't take out by only physical depth. The recovered fat is very, very pure. It has 99.2% to 6% purity. So that already gives it a rather high value. If you look to the business case, the payback time is roughly 3 years, which is very, very fast. And the reason is the client uses this oil to one side, use it for heating up the disconnector, which is roughly 50%. And the other 50% he can use for other purposes like their own steam production or their own hot water production. And it covers roughly 15% of the total energy consumption of the slaughterhouse. So there we already reduce a lot in the usage of natural gases or oil. Second to that, we also save in costs. If you look to the costs when you have not an Ecofat, roughly your cost would be 225,000 euros because we have less chemical costs, less disposal costs. Already there you see a saving of roughly 50,000 euros. Besides that, the whole, let's say, the whole installation was able to get an SDE subsidy, which is an additional benefit for the client. So that's another 150,000 euro annually. That's on annual basis. So in that way, we reduced the cost for the client, we reduced the chemical cost for the client, we reduced the sludge disposal cost for the client, we gave him a payback time. So in that way, we tried to solve the problem. And this is a case which we are seeing more and more, that the direction of the industrial wastewater treatment is going away from using chemicals and trying to solve it in a different way. Any questions? You can also contact my colleague, of course. But if there are any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. For your interesting presentation, showing another interesting business case where you can see that while looking at a smart way, at a non-traditional way of treating water, and in this case industrial water, can help to save energy and also to reduce sludge. Any questions from the audience? Yes, please.
Thanks. Nice presentation. You were mentioning that a part of the fat is used to heat up the water for fat removal. Why is that?
The disconnector itself is a heated tank. And for that, we need energy. So why not use the recovered fat out of the system to do that? So it's a self-sustaining system. 50% of the fat we burn in a boiler, and the boiler heats up water, and that's heating up that tank.
And the fat cannot be removed without heating?
No.
Okay, it will...
If you put it in a trichanter, you don't have that separation grade which you have now.
Okay.
So you need to heat it up, yes.
At which temperature this process is?
70 to 80 degrees.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Any other question? In the back, there is another question. Now.
Thanks for a very nice presentation. How important was the subsidy for the business case?
I will not deny it that for the client it was quite an important aspect of the whole story, the subsidy. Nevertheless, with 50% let's say savings on an annual basis, the payback time would not be 3-4 years, but you will go to 7 years. In the industry, 7 years is too long. Client will simply not invest in that payback time. Will that change in future? Yes, of course. If we look to gas prices, the business case nowadays is already different than in 2019, because the earnings which you have from, let's say, using this fat for heating up your own water is already much higher than it was 2 years ago. So business case changes and into the benefit of this. Secondly, another possibility which this client sometimes uses is to sell this fat to the biodiesel industry, where he's not using it for its own purpose, but he's selling it because that gives him even more money than replacing his own fuel. So every time the client is looking for the most optimum economical solution, and we see already that it's improving the business case. Yeah, but I admit the SDE subsidy was one of the concerns of the client to go for this. Yes, absolutely.
Okay. And is Nijhuis also actively looking in sales channels, for example, for this fat?
To yeah.
Have a more structural.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yeah. Thank you.
Any other questions from the audience? Well, maybe a more general question, but maybe also the audience can reflect on that. I looked at the internet, and I don't know if this is the slaughter. House, chicken slaughterhouse that you are working for, but in their goals, they say that they want to be climate neutral in 2035, I think it was. Yeah, and I was just wondering, this really contributes to that because you have an energy reduction and also a carbon dioxide reduction. Would there be other options, in your opinion, in the treatment process to contribute to that final goal to become climate neutral? Or should these industries more focus on their, let's say, internal production processes? So my question is, actually, what can the treatment process contribute to achieving this goal? More than you showed already.
Yeah. When I talk to these kind of the owners of these kind of companies, I always say to them, if you want to start earning money, buy brooms. And why am I saying that? Because in a lot of industries, the first reaction when there is dirt on the floor is to take water, flush it through the drainage system, and nobody sees it anymore. And it ends up in the wastewater treatment plant and it costs money. So I advise some of my clients, simply lock down all your gullies, buy brooms, and force the people first to clean it dry before you use water. It's essential, and that's where it starts. I think where it starts in the industry is the mentality, how you look at water. Because for a lot of the people working in the industry, it's a given fact, I have water, I can use it. And if you start thinking that water is not that much available, that only 6% of the water in the world is sweet water, which we are using. And if we put it into the drain, that we have to treat it with a lot of costs, then it starts at the source. That's one thing which is very, very important. Secondly, there is still a lot to gain on energy consumption inside the slaughterhouses. A lot of heat is lost. A lot of water is evaporated simply into the sky because of the hot circumstances. Well, if you look to there is a lot to gain, still a lot to gain.
And probably also with a positive business case.
And with positive business. In the end, the people in the industry look to business cases. If the business case is not correct, they don't invest. It's simple as that, because they don't make money with wastewater treatment. They make money with slaughtering chicken and selling meat. Okay. So that's absolutely key. The business case should be there.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your answer. Anyone wants to reflect on that or... No, well then, thank you once again.
Thank you very much.
And